We go to Colombia now. That's where the recent announcement that the country's decades-long military doctrine will be reviewed has been widely welcomed there, particularly among victims of state crimes. Natalia Margarita now with this story.
It was 1987 when Alejandra's father, a leader from the leftist Patriotic Union, was detained by the military, and one day later his body found with clear signs of torture. For Alejandra, her father is one of the many victims of Colombia's military doctrine, a strategy of counterinsurgency that was mainly directed against civilians.
If of every 10 victims of Colombia's armed conflict, 8 are civilians and just 2 members of either armed group. This is clearly a conflict where the victims, those who have paid the highest costs, are civilians. Those of us who have never carried a weapon but rather dedicated our lives to work in defense of human rights.
In the wake of an expected peace agreement, Colombian Army Commander General Alberto Mejia announced he has ordered a comprehensive review of the military doctrine, something that for victims is a must for constructing peace and providing guarantees of non-repetition.
The bad example that was put into practice by the military forces, for instance, through extrajudicial killings or the institutionalization of forced disappearances against those who think differently, is something that must be cut off from the roots.
The United States was central in defining Colombia's security strategy of counterinsurgency developed in the late 50s. Now, as military experts consider it urgent to review that doctrine, they have also expressed concerns that this would be done once again under the guidance of the United States and the NATO, as announced by the head of the Colombian Army.
It should be discussed with the social sector that are the ones directly affected by having security forces that are respectful of their rights and that put the arms at the service of democracy, not at the service of foreign interests or doctrines that have been used systematically, persecute civilians, victimize them, and that also have promoted paramilitarism, dirty war, and the extermination of all social movements.
The announced review of Colombia's military doctrine comes as the FARC top leader Timochenko confirmed he has ordered to halt military training, which might be giving signals that both sides are seriously preparing for peace.